I'm going to just go through how to photograph your model. So I'm just going to put my model against a dark background, which is just the side of my sofa. It could be a wall in your house, which is fine. Could be against a light background. I'm just going to do it against a dark background. First of all, I'm going to do a photo from above. So do it in a kind of well-lit area. Having the shadows is nice, so don't have a light directly over the top of it, or you won't get the shadows. So you can see that my buildings or my models are casting shadows, which is good. So photo from above, and then I'm going to take some photos from various angles, so we can see the 3D form of my model. I want to try and manipulate it so I don't get the edges of my sofa in and things like that. A good angle is low down, so if you hold your phone almost against the floor and take a photo, that's a really nice angle, which, you know, makes you feel like you're actually about to walk around that building. Obviously we can crop bits off later. I'm going to take a close-up of that part of the building, so you're just working your way around the model really, so we get an idea of the form and the structure of the building. So, okay, 5 or 6 photographs would be good. So I'm going to go into camera roll here and just have a quick look. I'm quite happy with those. Happy with that one. Happy with that one. Quite happy with that. Happy with that one. The aerial one, I'm just going to go to edit, and I'm just going to crop that one down to the shape of the landscape. And done. Now if you can create a box to do this in and use a dark background, white background, so that every side of the model is surrounded, then that would be great. I wouldn't recommend doing it on a patterned floor. Try and do it on a plain floor, plain carpet, plain kitchen floor, wherever it is you're going to do it, and a plain background, so that obviously if you've got a very busy patterned carpet, it doesn't interfere with the model. So some nice photographs of each of your configurations, of each of your models, would be great.